Welcome back to Great Day. Last week, we kicked off a new series called New You in 22. So this morning, we are helping you get back to the gym to maybe shed some of those pandemic pounds. But before you just jumped right into an exercise routine, you might want to listen to some advice from an expert.
Most people cannot start on January 1st and do 30 minutes of moderate exercise 5 days a week. Even if you do that, it is exceedingly unlikely that you are going to stay on this program for another week, right? And another week. So you don't have that exercise capacity. You don't have that ability to do what's recommended at this point. It's like your job is to empty a pool, but all you have is a Dixie cup. You're not going to be able to empty that pool. You need to get some different tool, like a bucket or, you know, backhoe, something bigger, right? Same thing here. If you want to follow these exercise recommendations, you need to develop an exercise capacity that allows you to do that without being miserable, without being sore, without being hurt, and over a long period of time. So that point, I call that the catching point, is 210 minutes, right? This is the ability to exercise in a moderate fashion, like a jog, for 30 minutes uninterrupted. When we get to that point, and we may not lose weight while we're doing this, while we're getting to this exercise capacity, but when you get to that point, the ability to stay on these programs and follow these recommendations gets much, much easier. So is it helpful to get other people involved, like a trainer, or is it better to go to the gym? This is a great question. There are certain things along the way in the last 10 years or so that we've discovered do indeed correlate with additional success down the road. Now, actually being with another person or actually having a trainer isn't necessarily the thing that correlates with success, but changing what we do on a week-to-week basis does. Instead of staying with the same program, for example, in our home, over and over and over, we want to introduce some variability. So it's not necessarily the presence of a trainer or the presence of a gym that's going to correlate with success. It's the presence of variability. So we want to make sure that based on what we're feeling, based on what our body is telling us, we put ourselves in the right position. And sometimes that means at the gym with a trainer. And sometimes that means at home on the couch. It's all about listening to your body's feedback so that you can stay on the program.
That doctor right there says your body will tell you when it needs rest and when it needs nourishment. He also says your willingness to listen and stay on the program at your body's pace is the key to success, even if it takes a little longer than expected. So good luck and stick with it. You're in for the long haul.